One of the greatest challenges in medical history was to find a cure for patients who suffered from organ failure, because the damage to the organ cannot be reversed or repaired. This is why organ transplantation is one of the greatest medical breakthroughs of all time. Transplantation is a surgical procedure in which tissue or an organ is transferred from one area of a person's body to another area, or from one person, called the donor, to another person, called the recipient. There are two types of organ transplantations, including allotransplantation and xenotransplantation. While allotransplantation involves the transplantation of an organ or tissue between two similar species, such as human to human, xenotransplantation involves a transplantation from one species to a different species, such as a pig to a human, and we will discuss xenotransplantation specifically. The applicability of xenotransplantation is of particular importance because there's a huge lack of human donors, so other animals serve as a great substitute to save the lives of patients with organ failure. The concept of xenotransplantation goes back all the way to the 17th century in France, where Dr. Jean-Baptiste Denis attempted the first sheep-to-human blood transfusion. Pigs, however, are great candidates for xenotransplantation nowadays due to the fast maturation of organs and similar physiology to the human anatomy.
In choosing the best candidate animal for xenotransplantation, researchers often narrow it down to pigs and primates. Some reasons that pigs are preferred over primates include the fact that pigs can be bred intensively with large litters, meaning the number of available organs could be increased rapidly. Keeping pigs in sterile conditions is relatively easy. Pigs do not resemble humans the same way primates do, making people feel less guilt when raising pigs for transplantation. And the use of pigs is considered by some as acceptable because of their production for food. While it does seem strange that the organs of a different animal could function properly in a new host, a 98% DNA match between humans and pigs leads to pig hearts having a very similar size, anatomy, and function to human hearts, and they are quite compatible. Both hearts contain four chambers, consisting of two ventricles and two atria. There are also four valves that are consistent with the valves in the human heart, and the aorta is in a similar position. These similarities allow for blood to flow through a pig heart the same way it flows through a human heart. In fact, prior to the first pig-to-human heart transplant, pig heart valves have been commonly used as replacements for human heart valves in past years. Despite the many similarities, there are also some key differences. For one, the shape of the pig heart is a typical Valentine heart shape, while the human heart is more of a trapezoidal shape. Pig hearts also tend to be larger than human hearts. Pigs are four-legged animals, and the heart is used to pumping horizontally, whereas in humans who stand upright, the heart pumps vertically. Additionally, in humans, the left atrium receives four pulmonary veins, whereas in pigs it receives only two pulmonary veins. There are also some occasions where the physiology and beat rate of a pig heart differs from that of a human heart and must be corrected. Although most of the differences seen are minimal and can be fixed with some traditional replumbing, they are still very important to consider during xenotransplantation.
After going through the taxing process of xenotransplantation, the journey does not end there, as there can be various post-transplant difficulties that a patient needs to deal with. The biggest concern post-surgery is rejection of the transplanted organ and increased susceptibility to secondary infections. Rejection is usually the primary concern following transplantation. The fear of rejection is even more amplified if the transplanted organ is from a non-human donor. Our body has curated mechanisms to prevent our immune system from attacking our own organs, tissues, and cells. However, any foreign material that enters our body is instantly eliminated by our immune system. Due to this process, an organ that comes from a different species is usually rejected within a few minutes in a process called hyperacute rejection. This is a process in which immune cells in the recipient's bloodstream attack the transplanted organ and eliminate it. The transplanted organ usually has antigens on its surface, which are like flags stating, "Hey, I am a pig heart, not a human heart," that signal the immune cells to trigger a defensive immune response, causing the organ to stop working. To bypass this mechanism of rejection, anti-rejection drugs, also known as immunosuppressive drugs, are administered to the patient. These drugs suppress the recipient's immune system, preventing it from being able to mount a strong response against the transplanted organ. Scientists have also been devising a mechanism to genetically modify the donor's genome to prevent rejection. However, despite these anti-rejection drugs and genetic modification, transplantation still poses a serious risk. One of these risks is the risk of infections. Because patients take immunosuppressive drugs, their immune system is weakened, making it unable to protect the body against foreign pathogens. These immunosuppressives can lead to a significant decrease in white blood cells, increasing susceptibility to many bacterial infections, making them more serious than they otherwise would be. Evidently, the new xenotransplantation of the pig heart is an amazing breakthrough in the medical field. However, it does not come without negatives. Patients will have to adhere to strict medical regimens like taking multiple immunosuppressive drugs and having regular doctor visits, which include sampling or biopsies of the transplanted heart tissue to check for rejection, which can be an anxiety-inducing process. The transplantation process is very energy taxing, and it can take several months for a person to gain their energy back.
With such an intense surgical procedure, crossing the barriers of animals and humans, you can imagine that there are quite a few ethical concerns regarding xenotransplantation. Let's delve into some of them. Firstly, many argue if it is right to harvest animals for their organs to save human lives. We do not have consent from these animals to do such a thing, and the unnatural living conditions which they are raised in is questionable. Animal rights movements also argue that raising pigs just to put their organs into humans is horrifying and inhumane. Another point is that how would you go about deciding who deserves the organ first? For example, a child who desperately needs an organ as soon as possible versus a mother of five who has been on the waiting list for a regular organ for a long time. In this case, how do we allocate the pig organs accordingly? Since the process is so new, would we create a waiting list or start giving them to those who need it most? What is fair and what is not? Certain religions and cultures also prevent pork consumption. In this case, xenotransplantation may not be suitable for them as they may not want a pig heart inside of them. So how would we go about accommodating for this? There is also the claim that xenotransplantation violates God's will. God preserves humans, so humans should preserve animals. Is it right to play God by crossing the barrier of species?
Throughout this video, we have discussed xenotransplantation, looking at the compatibility between human and pig hearts, post-transplant risk factors, and ethical concerns surrounding xenotransplantation. With many cardiovascular, kidney, liver, and lung diseases on the rise, coupled with the lack of people signing up as organ donors, there is a global organ shortage crisis. A potential solution that can improve and save lives is xenotransplantation. There is still a lot more research to be done, but with the first pig-to-human heart transplant completed, we are on our way there. For more information on this specific case, see part 2 of the series linked below. Thanks for watching.